by God and sanctified by our Lord Jesus Christ, and to be held in honor among all people. Thus, let us remember that this is a hallowed tradition, not to be entered into lightly, but with the reverence and respect that is deserved. Let us pray. Heavenly Lord, please look in favor upon David and Marissa as they come now to be joined in your holy name. May their love for each other continue to grow on this path upon which they will soon travel. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now let us read from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful, proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable, and it keeps no record of being wrong. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth is known. Love never gives up, never loses faith, is always hopeful and endures in all things. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love, the greatest of these is love. Let us read from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, Holy Father, I pray not only for these, but also for those who will believe in me through their word, so that they may all be one as you our Father in me and I in you, that they also may be in us, that the world may believe that you have sent me. And I have given them the glory you gave me, so that they may be one as we are one, I in them and you in me, that they may be brought to perfection as one, that the world may know that you sent me and that you love them even as you love me. Here in the scripture we have been given the definition of love, the definition of joy is what we're about to do today. Remember these words and go into faith. I now charge you both as you stand in the presence of God and these witnesses to remember that love and loyalty alone will serve as the foundations of a happy and enduring relationship. If you keep the vows that you are going to make and seek to follow the will of God, your life will be full of joy. And the home that you are establishing will abide through any change. Will you now take Marissa to be your lawful wedded wife? And in the presence of these witnesses, will you bow that you will fulfill the command? Will you stand by your 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 st they know that through any trials and hardships, that they may turn to your Son, our Supreme Counselor. May they follow the Holy Spirit on this journey and stay steadfast to your will. This we ask in the name of your Son, to whom all glory. Amen. May the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. David, you may now kiss your bride.